SpaceX launched astronauts for the first time barely a week ago. But CEO Elon Musk does not want the company resting on its laurels. Following the successful launch of the Crew Dragon capsule to the ISS, SpaceX boss Elon Musk has laid out the company's strategy. In a company email, Musk urged SpaceX employees to accelerate progress on its next-generation Starship, dramatically and immediately, a week after its historic first crewed mission to the International Space Station, ISS. Please consider the top SpaceX priority, apart from anything that could reduce Dragon return risk, to be Starship, Musk wrote on June 6th, Saturday, in the email. His space company launched a pair of NASA astronauts, Robert Behnken and Douglas Hurley, on a 19-hour journey to the ISS on May 30th, marking a historic first for SpaceX and a crucial step forward for the U.S. space program. A SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket and Crew Dragon capsule carried the astronauts to orbit and onto the International Space Station. That mission is ongoing, as Musk noted, with the spacecraft set to return the astronauts to Earth in the next couple months. While Falcon 9 currently operates as SpaceX's workhorse rocket for its cargo, satellite, and now astronaut missions, Musk evidently feels it's time to double down on efforts to develop the 120-meter-tall SpaceX Starship launch system, which comprises the Starship spacecraft and Super Heavy rocket that will carry it into orbit. In this video, Engineering Today will discuss why Elon Musk tells SpaceX to focus on Mars-bound Starship spacecraft dramatically and immediately. Let's get into details. SpaceX is now turning back to its primary aim of carrying humans and commercial cargo to the Moon, Mars, and beyond. The Falcon 9 rocket that launched the astronauts is the mainstay of SpaceX's business, with 85 missions over the past decade. Its Falcon 9 rockets are partially reusable, as the company often lands the large booster stage of the rocket and recovers the rocket's nose cone. But SpaceX eventually wants to replace both Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy with Starship, which should reduce cost by unifying its production lines and offering full reusability. Musk's goal is to make SpaceX Starship a fully reusable vehicle that can support both crew and cargo configurations, envisioning a rocket that's more akin to a commercial airplane, with short turnaround times between flights, and that can make trips to both Earth orbit and deep space destinations, including the Moon and Mars, when paired with the forthcoming SpaceX Super Heavy rocket booster. Musk last year unveiled the SpaceX Starship prototype, built of stainless steel and dwarfing the company's existing spacecraft. SpaceX is developing Starship with the goal of launching as many as 100 people at a time on missions to the Moon and Mars. So far, Starship has been in development at a SpaceX production and testing site in Boca Chica, Texas since 2019, and was originally being developed by a second team in parallel in Florida. SpaceX combined the efforts and focused prototype builds in Texas late last year and has been building a number of SpaceX Starship prototypes using a model of rapid iteration. While SpaceX has made progress on each iteration, development of the Starship has met with a number of challenges. So far, SpaceX Starship prototype succumbed to some failure during testing, either of its fuel compartments during pressure testing, or most recently, shortly after a static fire test of its engine. During the recent dramatic test firing of the craft's attached Raptor engine on May 29th, the company's fourth major prototype, dubbed SN4, went out in a blaze of glory. This lucky prototype had survived more rounds of testing than previous iterations, but still the loss of the craft is a bit of a setback for SpaceX. Unfortunately, what we thought was going to be a minor test of a quick disconnect ended up being a big problem, Musk said, referring to the explosion. Now we need to accelerate Starship progress, Musk said in Saturday's email. SpaceX will pick up Starship testing once more with SN5, the fifth prototype of Starship, which is expected to begin this week. SpaceX is now assembling the SN5 to continue its testing, even while SN6 and SN7 are also under construction. Musk's emphasis on SpaceX Starship comes 9 months after a controversial comment by NASA Administrator Jim Bridenstine, just before SpaceX unveiled the latest prototype. The NASA chief declared his agency wanted to see the same level of enthusiasm for SpaceX launching NASA astronauts as there was for the Starship program, saying it was time to deliver. At the time, Musk said, "From a SpaceX resource standpoint, our resources are overwhelmingly on Falcon and Dragon. It was really quite a small percentage of SpaceX on Starship, less than 5% of the company, basically. The really hard part that requires a lot of resources is optimizing something and bringing it into volume production. To be clear, the vast majority of our resources are on Dragon and Falcon, especially Crew Dragon." Now, with SpaceX having delivered on the first part of its commitment to fly NASA astronauts, Musk is turning the company's attention to Starship. SpaceX has raised nearly $1.7 billion since the beginning of 2019, with its valuation rising to about $36 billion. The company has steadily raised funding as it's developed three ambitious programs: the Crew Dragon spacecraft, its Starlink internet satellites, and the massive Starship rocket. The SpaceX Starship program has seen prototypes pass several critical milestones, but SpaceX has yet to begin flight testing its most recent design. The company launch vehicle won't be ready until 2022 at the very earliest, although it has completed several successful hop tests, including tethered launches and landings. Musk confirmed on Twitter that he plans to stick to his ambitious launch schedule of firing the first ships towards Mars by 2022. These missions will haul cargo designed to support future manned missions to the Red Planet. Musk previously said that the lifetime of each SpaceX Starship will be around 20 to 30 years, like an aircraft. Around 3 Starship flights will launch from Earth per day, or around 1,000 flights a year, and each will have a capacity of more than 90,000 pounds. By continuously ferrying people the 180 million miles to Mars, Musk is predicting 1,000 human inhabitants by 2030 and maybe around 1 million by 2050. Musk thinks each Starship mission could launch for $2 million, with an individual ticket one day costing less than $500,000 and maybe even below $100,000. Speaking at South by Southwest, the billionaire hinted that people whose bank balance is in the red will also be allowed to live on the Red Planet. It's unclear whether they would actually want to do this because life on Mars is likely to be pretty rubbish at first. According to Musk, time is against us. He responded to a tweet suggesting that in a few billion years, the sun will explode and Earth will be decimated. Of course, so will Mars, but that's besides the point. That's when all life on Earth will be boiled off, he tweeted on the 4th of June, Thursday. What matters is how long civilization is capable of making the jump to Mars. This could be a very short period of time, measured in decades. It took 4.5 billion years to get to this point, and civilization isn't looking super stable. SpaceX continues to build up its facility in Boca Chica, an area along the Gulf of Mexico at the most southern part of the U.S. and Mexico border in Texas. Musk noted that he's often been on site at Boca Chica recently and continues to do so. On Saturday, he tweeted an aerial view of the complex, showing its growing array of production tents and rocket manufacturing bays. Musk says in the email that SpaceX employees should consider spending significant time in Boca Chica development site to help further accelerate Starship development. The company now has a bit more time pressure driving SpaceX Starship's development, since it was selected as one of 3 suppliers for NASA's human lunar lander contracts, with Starship intended to act as a last-mile transportation system for taking astronauts from NASA's lunar gateway to the surface of the moon. SpaceX has about 8,000 employees, most of whom are at the company's Los Angeles area headquarters or its facilities at Cape Canaveral, Florida, or near Austin, Texas. Musk's email implied that the company is seeking to incentivize employees to move to Texas from California and Florida. "For those considering moving, we will always offer a dedicated SpaceX aircraft to shuttle people," Musk wrote. SpaceX owns and operates at least one private jet, as the company has charged Tesla $200,000 for use of its private jet in the first quarter of 2020. But the extraordinary relocation offer underlines how crucial Musk sees the SpaceX Starship project. The company's Boca Chica team is already working nearly round the clock, but Musk wants more, urging SpaceX employees to help Starship development progress even more quickly. There's still a long way to go, of course, and whether it will actually be successful is anyone's guess. For the time being, at least, however, Musk is putting SpaceX's full might behind it. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.